Wanted a real breakfast this morning, so made myself a real breakfast. Burnt the bacon, though. A little bit. It's crispy. Be fine. It'll be fine. It's been a minute since I came to the park. Trying to get my Foursquare mayorship back. Just also get some steps in. Today is technically a rest day, but I want to keep it moving. Gotta stay active, right, Art? Gotta stay active, get these steps in, and also get a little sunshine. I want to be cooped up in the apartment all day and not actually get recharged by the sun's rejuvenating rays. All right, I'm gonna post up here for a minute simply because I just wanna stop and just take in nature, I guess. So I'm very sure y'all are familiar with the tale of the tortoise and the hare. Well, the other day, a friend sent me this video. I guess the video is going viral, I don't know. But it is of an actual race between a tortoise and a hare or a rabbit or whatever. Slow-moving creature in a shell versus a rather quick, fluffy, cute creature. So whatever. So here's the video. Check it out. Now it's really funny because it plays out exactly as the Aesop fable played out. The tortoise was victorious. And I mean, you know, yeah, sure, you know, the little bunny stopped and was like staring and everything, you know, there's a dog off to the side and, you know, maybe the dog kind of like scared the little bunny or whatever, but the point is the bunny stopped. So despite having the advantage of speed, natural ability of speed on its side, it just stopped. It just didn't continue. Whereas the tortoise plodded along until it crossed the finish line. And that really is like a life lesson. Slow but steady wins the race. Or as my boy Ron Worthy always says, it's a marathon, not a sprint. So you just, you keep going, you keep going at length. I guess Ron's analogy isn't really applicable here, but whatever, I felt like saying it. Shout out Ron Worthy. But the point is, don't give up in the face of adversity, even if your opponent could easily like beat you, whatever we're talking about here, you've got to persevere. You can't stop. All right, let me get these steps in. I've been chilling a little too long. Let's go. Okay. It was a little warm outside, so I had to bring it back to the apartment. The whole point of me sharing the tortoise and hare video, though, is because it's analogous, I feel, to my growth on YouTube. I did not set out to become like some big world famous YouTuber or anything like that. I just want to set this up so that my family and friends could keep up with me on my journey out here in LA. But as time has gone on, you know, I've really developed an affinity for the platform, for, you know, these videos that I'm making, and I am trying to make them better. Like, I'm trying to create like the best content that I can. I'm taking this seriously, even though this is my creative outlet outside of writing. And as I mentioned, you know, in another video, like this is my second film school. This is me getting to learn about the equipment and techniques and just all sorts of things. You know, this is my second film school. And I haven't experienced the explosive kind of rise in viewers that some YouTubers have. And I attribute that to a lot of things. You know, number one, I mean, my videos are just of me and who am I? Nobody knows who I am. I'm not all that interesting. I'm not young and pretty. But slowly, I guess I am building an audience. I just hit 500 subscribers the other day. what? And again, I know that that's not a huge number, but I'm impressed. And I'm actually kind of humbled and thankful that at some point, 500 people became so invested in me and in my journey that they subscribed to my channel. And of course, this doesn't mean that everyone watches like every video that I put up. And I mean, that's totally fine. But again, you know, just to reach this minor milestone, it means a lot to me. And I've really only been doing the YouTube thing for about 2 years, like really taking it seriously for about the last 2 years. And I know that some people have grown, you know, by the thousands, you know, thousands over thousands in that time. But hey, you know, we have to celebrate our victories when we get them. And I'm counting 500 subscribers as a victory. So thank you. I cheers my water to you. And yeah, I ain't gonna lie, like when I saw that I hit 500, I totally took myself out to celebrate. Went to the spot, had a couple of tequilas and sodas. Tequila and not vodka. Got down on that Casamigos. It's good shit. I see you, George Clooney and Cindy Crawford's husband. I forget your name right now. I see y'all though. Good tequila. I like it. And even though I was out, still ate healthy-ish. Got myself a Cobb salad. I've always enjoyed Cobb salads anyway, so, you know, anything. Although I'm pretty sure the sodium in that Cobb salad was through the fucking roof, but whatever. I digress. I did celebrate. Because you gotta celebrate your wins. We all have to celebrate our wins, no matter how small they may seem to others. Gotta celebrate your wins. And I just figure, you know, if I continue to do the best that I can and make honest content and hopefully improve, maybe that number will rise. Maybe I'll hit the 1,000 subscriber mark and maybe start making some money off these videos. But it's a process. It's a process. You know, it's gonna take time. And I feel like as long as I'm consistent and as long as I keep plodding along just like that tortoise, I'm gonna win my race. And here's the thing, it's not just with YouTube, but I feel like, you know, if I apply that to all areas of my life, including and especially my screenwriting career, which I've been at for decades, it's been hard to watch some people who just discovered screenwriting last year and all of a sudden, you know, they are where I wanna be. But I feel like if I keep at it, I will get there eventually. And that victory will ultimately prove to be very satisfying and rewarding. And I'm looking forward to that. Whew. Okay, I've cooled down some. Gonna get some more water, because does a body good. Well, that's milk, but water does a body good too. You know what I'm talking about. Don't give up. Keep pushing. Even in the face of insurmountable odds, just keep going. Because the race is yours. Just gotta cross that finish line.